laptop gets hot. Does yours get hot? It's freaking.
Oh, wow.
Like, it does, and I have a fan that I always use with it, but it gets hot.
Yeah, yours gets really hot.
And I don't...
It's recording.
I know, but I'm going to edit this. And this is behind the scenes. People like behind the scenes.
They do. Camera space.
What? So we're back, part two, and this time we're going to be talking about our SLRs. Can you see that? That is probably the camera that you're most familiar with. Either you had them when you were younger, or you have them now, but you have a digital one.
Or you had to take a photo class when you were in high school.
This is probably the camera that you would have used. See? Mine's black.
Or possibly this one if you, you know, went to school a long time ago.
What is yours?
Mine is a Minolta.
And mine is a Canon Rebel G.
SRT-101.
Single lens reflex. There's one lens.
And there's a mirror, and it goes right into your, what do you call this, view slot? I teach this in a class.
Viewfinder.
Viewfinder, there we go. Viewfinder.
We are professionals in our own definition of
that
word.
I'm a fucking teacher. I teach this shit.
If you see any of the photos we've been taking and scanning and uploading, I took all of mine with my SLR, the 35mm ones, and did you use yours?
Nope, because I brought my very broken OM2.
You did, that's right.
Yep.
That's right. So, we're going to show you how to load it. It's pretty easy, and it's going to be different because mine will do it automatically, and Valerie will do it herself.
So mine is only a manual. It doesn't have anything fancy.
Which is how they originally were, so.
Now, the first thing you want to do is you want to look at your ASA and make sure you match your ASA to your film, because if you don't do that first thing, you'll probably forget, because that's what I do.
And that's the film speed. We talked about it in the last blog entry. If you didn't read it, go back and read it. This says, I don't mean to interrupt you. This says 100 T-Max.
And this is set at 400. So I want to pull this up and set it, not to 800, but to 100.
So that way the camera is talking to the negative.
So to open up the back, you pull on the winder, and it pops open with a spring. It's real fancy.
Fancy. We like it.
And then you just, I can't see what's happening. All right.
You got it.
And so then you put the film in, and much like Mary's, you just pull it over till it catches. But then you gotta,
nope, camera fail.
Let's see.
Just say.
All right.
Can I hold something?
No, I totally got this.
Okay, I'm not doubting your skills.
All right, nice and slow, catching there. Yeah, there we go.
All right. And then you feel so proud of yourself. I mean.
Then you just snap it closed, and you hit the button, and pull it a couple times.
You do have to set your aperture and your shutter speed to what the correct number should be according to what the conditions are outside.
And to do that, it has a meter inside of
it. It does, a meter that measures the light to see how long your shutter should stay open, how much light should be let through, things like that, so you don't get an image that's too dark or too light.
Change this to on to turn on your meter inside. And then when you look through here, through your viewfinder, you'll see a little bar that tells you when you've got it at the right exposure.
And there's a lot of other things that go into it. Honestly, what we're doing is just introducing you to our cameras. So we realize we're leaving out all you professional photographers out there. Don't get worried. We know we're leaving shit out. But this is just so that you know when you see a photo of mine or hers that's 35mm, this is probably what it was taken with. And these are wonderful. And they're film. And you just can't beat them. So now you know what a Holga is from the previous one, and you know what an SLR 35mm is. So go out there, dust yours off, because I know you've got one like that out there.
We know you have this in your closet. If you don't, your uncle does.
Exactly.
Hound him. He'll give it to you. He doesn't want it.
He doesn't know how to use it anymore.
Yeah, he's not going to go to Walgreens and get the film developed.
You can do Walgreens for this stuff if it's color. Black and white, you do still have to go to a camera store. But you can do color regularly, an hour developed at Walgreens, you're done. And it's beautiful.
You can even get your film at Walgreens.
Exactly.
It's so easy.
It really is. Okay, people.
Are we just doing a plug-in for Walgreens?
Yeah.
Should we contact them? Let's go see if they'll pay us something. Okay, let's do that.
I just like them and they're around the corner.
They are around the corner.
You could go to Rite Aid too. I have nothing against Rite Aid.
They will flip their shit if you ask them for just development.
They don't understand that because we scan our negatives in, or if we had a dark room, eventually we will. We'll we'll print them ourselves, so we don't need anything but the negatives. And they don't like that.
No, they don't.
They're like confused.
If you say don't cut them, then it's like, whoa, what do you mean? What do you mean don't cut?
It's like going into Starbucks and ordering a small coffee. They're not sure what that is. Is it grande? Is it a soy latte? Is it cappuccino Americano with a red eye shot? No, motherfuckers.
Would you like a flavor in that?
I am that person in line that holds you up just because I want a small coffee and I didn't know that I had to order something that had 15 different names. All right. I think we're done with our rant.
All right.
And with our cameras.
I think this will have to be edited. It's 11 minutes.